Hi, I'm Rick here in Betty's Kitchen, and it's day three of Dog Week. And today I'm going to Chicago for the famous Chicago-style hot dog. I've been making these for years, and I've enjoyed them for years. So I pretty much know my way around these. We begin with the dogs, as always, all beef hot dogs. And I have, the classic dirty water method, in which you bring water to a boil, put your dogs in, turn it down to a simmer and cook for about 8-10 minutes. You don't want to overcook them. You want them to be good and hot, maybe swell up a little bit. Again, I'm using these Oscar Mayer Selects with very little filler or chemicals of any sort. So I think they're probably healthier, better for you. So I'm going to wait about 8 minutes or so for these dogs to cook. I'm going to steam the buns a little bit at the end of that process, and we'll be back. Buns are steamed, the dogs are done, and ready to assemble. Some assembly required for Chicago dogs. This is a very strict, rigid protocol for these dogs. People in Chicago don't mess around. They have a way of doing it, and that's the only way. But I've got my hot dog mise en place set up here. Quite a oxymoron, I guess. I'll assemble one real quick. Squirt of yellow mustard comes first, always yellow mustard. And then sweet pickle relish, preferably the neon green type. Some chopped onions. Some tomato slices, or wedges, actually. Some people chop them, but I like the wedges. They stay in place better. Now some pickles. You have one dill spear, and you have two little pepperoncini pickles, or sport peppers is what they use in Chicago, but I understand the pepperoncinis are pretty much the same thing. And the last item is a good shake of celery salt, which doesn't sound like it would make any difference, but trust me, it does. I'd miss it if I don't have it. So that's a traditional Chicago-style dog. I know I'm gonna like this because, like I said, I've been making them for years. But when you think about it, it really is pretty much a complete meal. You got your salad, you got your side dish, you got your bread, you got your entree. I mean, slide a Hershey bar in there for dessert and you got everything. But I'll go ahead and taste it anyway, just to confirm what I already know, that it's good. Notice the poppy seed bun. I didn't really say anything about it, but that's traditional for the Chicago dog. It's hot dog bliss. I love them. They're a strange bunch of taste coming together, sweet, sour, spicy, salty. It's everything, but it just flat works. And that's maybe why the Chicago ones are so particular about having these particular ingredients and not deviating, but it is good. I love it. Betty, you wanna try it? She's nodding, so we'll be right back.
I'm gonna take a taste of one of these Chicago hot dogs, and Rick fixed one, especially for me. It's right over here at the end. I thought I probably would not like, what was it? It was the chopped onion. I generally don't like raw onion, because it seems to linger with me all afternoon and I don't want that. And also I had the dill pickle left out, so mine is over here and it's a little unmanageable, but I'll go ahead and pick it up. And I have never eaten one of these. Rick loves them and I trust his judgment, but a lot of times we will make our separate meals because we have really different tastes. You might think that we always eat what is presented on Betty's Kitchen in unison, but that's not the case. Sometimes he feels like a hot dog, and sometimes I feel like a grilled cheese sandwich and tomato soup or something like that. So we just make our own meals. But I'm going to taste this and give you my honest opinion. I'm always honest. I didn't get everything. So I'm gonna take a bite here. of that. And that, I think I got the rest. It's good. So, for my size down Chicago hot dog, the flavors are really great. They go together really well, and this was a good choice for me. Now, I'm sure the whole thing is what most people would like, but I can recommend it because it tastes very good just here on my first try. And I've got my iced tea, which I can hardly do without. Thanks for watching, and there will be a fourth hot dog video coming up soon. I'm finna get a hot dog. I'm finna get a hot dog.